feel like old Ned. Wished I was dead. What did I do to be so black and blue?
Black and Blue by Louis Armstrong. Armstrong was a black singer and jazz musician during the early and mid-1900s. Louis was a part of the Harlem Renaissance, which was an era that marked the beginning of the black progressivism during the 20th century. The Harlem Renaissance granted African-American artists like Louis Armstrong a high place in society in a very anti-equal time. Langston Hughes was the leader of the Renaissance. Hughes would write poems which accentuated the discrimination of blacks in the 20th century. The Harlem Renaissance is also known as the Jazz Age, as jazz was one of the main factors that created the era. The Great Depression, the end of the Roaring Twenties, as well as the Harlem Renaissance. During the 30s, there was no room for oppression, as three-fourths of America was facing financial crises. World War II, the bloodiest conflict in history. Even then, America was still recovering and saving the failed economic crisis that was the Great Depression. 1.2 million black Americans served in the bloodiest conflict in history. That's 13% of all soldiers who fought in the war. Although these black men served in the armed forces, they were heavily segregated and rarely moved up ranks. Black squads were commanded by white commanding officers. Some black American fighters shine through and are publicized today, such as the Tuskegee Airmen. Yet at the time, rarely any blacks were recognized for their valor.
Well, for the past 10 years, the struggle in America has been confined to what has been projected to the public as a civil rights struggle. And in that context, it has remained a domestic problem. It has remained within the jurisdiction of the United States, and as such, it has been impossible for the Afro-Americans or American Negroes to try and enlist the support of other dark-skinned people who are being oppressed the world over in that struggle.
This is Malcolm X, a civil rights activist who led a pro-black extremist movement that supported blacks as dominant. The civil rights movement lasted from the late 40s to the late 60s. The movement stemmed from a public outcry on how the black community was being treated primarily in the South, but as well as in the North. Segregation was a big problem in public places and divided people of color away from the whites. Activists highlighted how although laws have been passed to protect against racism, racism was still very dominant in America and becoming a major problem in the black community. Activists such as Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, as well as groups as the Black Panther Movement, developed methods of handling the systematic racism. The Civil Rights Movement came to a close when the 36th President of the United States, Lyndon B. Johnson, signed the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which was legislated by John F. Kennedy before his assassination.
We must not approach the observance and enforcement of this law in a vengeful spirit. Its purpose is not to punish. Its purpose is not to divide, but to end divisions, divisions which have lasted all too long. Its purpose is national, not regional. This Civil Rights Act is a challenge to all of us to go to work in our communities and our states, in our homes and in our hearts, to eliminate the last vestiges of injustice in our beloved country. So tonight I urge every public official, every religious leader, every business and professional man, every working man, every housewife, I urge every American to join in this effort to bring justice and hope to all our people and to bring peace to our land.